show. Now, with a performance on this year's Grammys dedicated solely to electronica and a new Simon Cowell show in the works all about DJs, it's pretty clear that DJs are the new rock stars, right? Would you guys agree or no? So I wanted to basically step you guys at home through what all this stuff means, you know, the ones and twos and the turntables. So to help me out is DJ to the Stars, DJ Kiss. Welcome to the show, Kiss.
Thank you.
Now, you're playing massive parties. You played Puffy's party. You just DJed at the Knicks at Madison Square Garden.
I did.
Give us a little indication of how your career started and how you got to where you are now.
Well, I'm really fortunate because my hubby, who was my boyfriend at the time, actually taught me to DJ. But even with him helping me, it still took me about 6 months to a year to get good enough to actually play a club.
Yeah, that's the same as me. I played in my bedroom for like 5 years or something. My mom would always be bashing on the wall, turn it down.
Yeah.
And then somebody gives you a start in a club at an early hour, like 5 o'clock.
Exactly.
And then you work it up and then you get on and then you get the good sets.
Exactly. Yeah. And then once I started getting my own residencies, it was just a matter of being in the right place at the right time, and then someone got to hear me and wanted me to do their party, and my career kind of took off from there.
And then you're playing for Diddy and you're just killing it.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. All right, so what's the fundamentals, besides the equipment, what's the actual breakdown fundamentals of being a DJ? What does it mean to be a DJ?
Okay, the fundamental part of being a DJ is song selection.
Yeah.
That is picking the best songs for the right party for the right time.
Okay. So if you're someone at home who likes to do playlists and you do it really well, then maybe you're the person who'd be a good DJ.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. So like iTunes, there's a new program now called Spotify.
Spotify is really interesting because you can actually create playlists and then share them with people. Mm-hmm. So that's a really good start if you're interested in being a DJ, is programming music on that program.
Great. And Spotify is free. So if you go in and grab that, you can share playlists for free. It's really cool. Good way to get into putting song selection together. Okay, so now we've got this gear here.
Okay.
Let's talk through exactly what we've got going on in front of us.
All right, so we have 2 turntables, we have our mixer, and now most DJs use this program called Serato Scratch Live, which is kind of industry standard, and it allows you to take your MP3s and beam them to control records so that you can mimic actually DJing on vinyl.
Okay, sweet. So it used to be 2 turntables and a mic, and now it's 2 turntables and a Mac. So that's how it's all changed, right? Okay, cool.
Exactly.
So we're playing digitally from the laptop onto the analog records.
Yes.
Okay, right. Now, what's the first thing? Someone at home goes out and buys all this setup.
Okay.
What's the first thing they need to know how to do to go from one song to another song?
You have to beat match.
Okay.
Which means, so some songs are slow, some songs are fast.
Yep.
It's all about your beats per minute. And you have to really match those beats per minute so that you can switch songs seamlessly and no one kind of knows where one song starts and one begins.
Okay, great. So let's give an example of that. So play this song here, and
all right,
this song is 126 beats per minute. Right, so that's beat A. Now the second song's playing Kiss's ear, and her job is to line it up together at the same tempo by adjusting the pitch here. And then you want to basically crossfade it over. There's a little party going on in the studio. So let's give an example of how it sounds though when it doesn't match up, just so you can hear when it's wrong, okay?
If it didn't match up, it would sound like this.
There, you hear that kind of clutter?
It sounds
going
horrible,
on?
Right?
Yeah, it's
that
not good,
not
it's not good.
Good.
Okay, yeah. You're getting booed out of the nightclub. All right, so match it up, beat match it. And basically what we're doing is, imagine 2 balls of the 2 records, right? 2 bouncing balls, don't be rude. And you wanna sync them up like this. I'm gonna stop that hand movement. Because my audience are like juvenile. Okay, so beat match these 2 up. So she's got 1 song playing now. And that's actually 2 songs. Okay, so you can't even tell. So she's seamlessly flowing the playlist. So that's sort of the basic thing that you want to do once you get your turntable set up at home, is you want to learn how to beat match so you can get the party flowing and you don't have any breaks, because that's the idea, right? You want to keep the momentum.
Right. And it takes a while to learn how to do that, actually, believe it or not. But once you got it, you got it.
It took me a year to do that, a year. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put those skills to test, and we're going to do like a little 4 or 5 song mashup where you got to beat match it all live. And then just mash it all up together.
All right, you want to start us off with a little something?
Yeah, I'll start a song.
On VH1's big morning buzz live.
I feel so close.
Maybe we can all come in and dance, yeah? So she's starting off with a little Calvin Harris. On my sleeve like a big deal. And what she's doing now is she's just playing the cool thing, you know? Part of the DJ.
And there's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now.
So each song has like an 8-bar that you want to drop it on. So she's dropped the second track on there. She's got a beat match and she's going to fade in and switch it over to set. Listen. So there goes track two. That's Avicii. So, Kiss, I'm going to let you keep playing.
All right.
Thank you so much for coming on. I hope you guys at home learned a little bit about the fundamentals of DJing, beat matching, fading between songs. Coming up after the break, we've got more business. Big morning buzz, so don't go anywhere. We'll see you in a minute. Keep it going, Kiss.